Now let's see the last topic in adsorption. Its applications. Applications of adsorption in various fields. See the first application. To produce high vacuum. To produce high vacuum. You know, in some containers, there must not be air. Suppose in the extraction of magnesium, in the extraction of sodium, which are active metals highly, if any traces of air is present, what happens is they react with air. That's why yield of that magnesium or sodium decreases. So for that purpose, there must be vacuum. To create vacuum, there activated charcoal will be kept. What is that? Activated charcoal. This activated charcoal adsorbs the gases, nitrogen, oxygen, CO2. These gases are adsorbed by activated charcoal. Then what happens if oxygen, nitrogen, CO2 are absent? Then the extracted metal, sodium or magnesium, does not react. Why? There is no substance to react. That's why. So in that way, to produce a high vacuum, we use activated charcoals. Similarly, second one, in gas masks. Gas mask. So generally, in the industry where poisonous gases are released, the industrial workers must use gas masks. Why? These gas masks contain activated charcoal and some other adsorbents. These adsorbents adsorb the poisonous gases released from the industry. It adsorbs more the poisonous gases without affecting the breathing. In breathing, some other gases also required, oxygen. This gas is also required. So we know that oxygen, nitrogen, these are non-easily liquefiable gases. So they are adsorbed to very lesser extent. But poisonous gases like HCl, ammonia, SO2, chlorine, these are easily liquefiable gases. So they are adsorbed more. So for that purpose, activated charcoal and some other adsorbents are in gas masks also, because of adsorption process, poisonous gases are adsorbed. Third one, to control humidity. Humidity means moisture in the atmosphere. So if there is more humidity, there will be more sweating. So control humidity in the room, just place some silica gel or alumina gel. Silica gel or alumina gel, if it is kept in your room, what happens is its humidity decreases. So to control humidity, adsorption is involved. Fourth one. In heterogeneous catalysis, what is heterogeneous catalysis? Previously, I have discussed that. Heterogeneous catalysis means if the catalyst used and the reactants are in the same phase, that means either in solid phase, liquid phase, or gas phase, generally liquid or gas phases. So if a catalyst and the reactants are in the same phase, that is called heterogeneous catalysis. Just like a hydrogenation of alkenes, hydrogenation of oils to fats, these are heterogeneous. There which catalyst is used? Yes, nickel. So use of nickel in the hydrogenation of alkenes or oils is an example for heterogeneous catalysis. There what happens is all the reactants they first adsorbed on the surface of nickel, that means adsorbent. From there they react and form products, and finally they leave the surface. So using adsorption process, reactants are converted into products in the heterogeneous catalysis. So in this process we use nickel or platinum or palladium for hydrogenation of alkenes. Fifth one, curing of diseases. Curing of diseases. In this, generally for curing the diseases we use drugs. These drug particles kill the germs, that means bacteria, fungus, whatever it may be. These drugs usually kill the germs by getting themselves adsorbed on the surface of those germs. So these particles are adsorbed on the surface of germs. So from there they kill that disease causing germs. Okay, so that also involves adsorption. Sixth one, decolorization. Decolorization of molasses. You know, molasses is the liquor left after the crystallization of cane sugar. After the preparation of sugar, some liquor will be left over. That left liquor molasses is used further for the preparation of ethyl alcohol. Before the preparation, it is to be decolorized because there are some colored impurities. Because of that colored particles, it appears somewhat dark. So ethyl alcohol, to get colorless, those impurity particles which are suspended, which are dispersed in molasses, must be removed. That's why for that process animal charcoal is used. What is that? Animal charcoal. When the dirty, that means black colored molasses is sent through animal charcoal, the charcoal simply adsorbs the color causing impurities from the molasses. In that way, colorless molasses will be obtained, that is subjected to further methods to prepare ethyl alcohol. This is sixth one. Next, seventh one. Froth flotation. What is this? This is the method used for the purification of minerals or ores. About this topic, froth flotation, we discuss it in, there is a chapter, metallurgy. This froth flotation process is especially for the purification of sulfide minerals, galena, PbS, zinc blende, ZnS, copper pyrites, iron pyrites. These are all examples for sulfide minerals. These minerals are concentrated, that means refined, purified. Concentration means removal of impurities from the mineral. So sulfide minerals are refined using froth flotation process, which also involves adsorption process. There sulfide mineral particles get adsorbed on the surface of some sodium ethyl xanthate. Sodium ethyl xanthate, there is a chemical that is added, so which acts as collector. So that collector collects all these by adsorption. That is froth flotation. Eighth one, cleansing action of soaps and detergents. Cleansing action of soaps and detergents. So about this cleansing action of soaps and detergents, we have a topic in the surface chemistry. Later we have a topic called colloids. There I will discuss this cleansing action of soaps and detergents also involves adsorption. Okay, ninth one. Chromatography. You know, we have different types of chromatography. Chromatography is nothing but separation and detection of different compounds present in a mixture. Here we may use adsorption chromatography or partition chromatography. In adsorption chromatography, based on the extent of adsorption of components in the mixture, we separate the components of mixture. Here also, in adsorption chromatography, we use either silica gel or alumina gel. Silica gel or alumina gel. Okay. Next, 10th one, adsorption indicators. Adsorption indicators. You know, some silver halides, silver chloride, bromide, iodide, these are used as indicators in some precipitation reactions. These indicators show color change at the end point because of adsorption. They adsorb some colored dyes like eosin, fluorescein. So, like eosin, fluorescein, these are organic colored dyes. By absorbing those colored dyes, they show color change at the end point. Finally, separation of inert gases. Separation of inert gases. Inert gases means noble gases. Okay. So, here we use coconut charcoal. What is that? Coconut charcoal. So we have a method, Dewar's method. In that method, we separate all the noble gases. You know, air contains helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, except radon. All the noble gases are present in air, but to very small extent. So air is a mixture of both several gases, nitrogen, oxygen, CO2, so many gases there are. Contribution of noble gases in air is only 1%. That 1% noble gas mixture can be separated by this adsorption technique. So the details of this Dewar's method, that means adsorption of noble gases on coconut charcoal, you will learn in a chapter, noble gases. There is a chapter in first year. So there you can learn about this process. Okay, these are the different applications of adsorption.